Why Jesus? That's a great question. It's a question the world's been asking for over 2,000 years because Jesus is still one of the most controversial and compelling figures in world history. It's a question I ask in my own life, and it's a question I certainly asked when I moved to Portland to start a church. Portland is famously known as one of the least religious cities in America, and as a pastor, that's one of the things I kind of love about Portland. Let me tell you why. When we first moved here, we did what we always did in ministry. We just started talking to people about life and not just the nice, pretty topics you're supposed to talk about, all of life, because I think real life happens in really good conversation. And so I got some friends together because I really just wanted to see what conversations are people having in Portland. We actually did a survey, and to date, we've talked to about 8,000 people about what they believe about God right here in Portland. And the results were pretty surprising. Well, the first thing that we learned wasn't that surprising. Most people in Portland don't want to have anything to do with religion. In fact, a lot of people moved here to get away from it. So I totally understand that. The second thing that we learned is that people actually really like to talk about Jesus. We found that 96% of people in downtown Portland had a favorable view of Jesus. And the third question was really the shocker. We asked people, if you could know God in a personal way, would you want to? What would your answer be? I was so surprised to find that after talking to 8,000 people, over 84% of people said yes. And here's what that taught me, is that people want to know if there is a way to know God without religion. And so back to our original question, why Jesus? I think that's the answer. The reason that we are so compelled to follow Jesus, the reason I follow Jesus in my own life, is because Jesus offers a way to God. Let me just contrast some things for you quickly. I think that essentially religion says this, find a way to get to God. But Jesus says this, God has found a way to come for you. I think that deep down, we're asking lots of questions all of the time. One of the questions I've heard from myself and from others is there more to life than this? And in the person of Jesus, we have the answer to that question. One of the most audacious claims Jesus ever made was this. Here's what he said. I have come to give you life and life to the full. It was so incredible that he said this. And then he went on to make this audacious statement. He said, I am the way, I am the truth, I am the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. And so why are we still talking about Jesus? Is it because he healed the sick and loved the leper and gave dignity to the people on the fringes of society? Yes, but that's not the only reason. The reason that Jesus remains one of history's most compelling and controversial figures is that Jesus never claimed just to be good. Jesus claimed to be God, and that by knowing Jesus, we can know our Creator in His fullness. That's a stunning proposition. Here's how it works. The Bible's message about Jesus teaches this, that all of us are born with a distance from God, and that distance is defined by a condition of our hearts called sin. Now, a lot of us think of sin as behaviors that we do or don't do, but the Bible teaches a much fuller picture of sin, that sin is actually a condition of our hearts. It's very much like a disease. And like any other disease, sin has a nature, and the nature is destruction. Sin is the condition of our hearts that has led us to our biggest mistakes. Sin is the condition of our hearts that has caused us our deepest regrets. Sin is the condition that keeps us from doing the things that we know we should do and causes us to do things that we wish we didn't do. Sin is the cause of addiction and evil and turmoil in our lives and around the world. And when you describe it like that, it's easy to see why God hates sin. God hates the impact that sin has on our lives. And sin separates us from God. But there's a second truth that makes this story so much sweeter. Because let me just pause. Religion says you've got to deal with your own sin. Jesus knew we could never deal with our own sin. And so he came for us. And that leads us into the second picture that we see in the gospel, is that God yearns for sinners. I think the reason that so many people hate religion is deep down, religion has taught a message that God doesn't want anything to do with people who sin. I just wish that lie could be exposed for what it is, because the truth of the Bible, written throughout time, given to us by God so that we might know Him, says that God never, ever, ever stopped yearning for sinners. I don't care how far you've been. I don't care what you've done. I don't care how bad you think you've messed up. Here's what you need to know the Bible says about you. God has never stopped wanting you. In fact, in the scripture, here's what the Bible says, that even though we are sinners, Christ died for us. The gospel teaches that Jesus came to do the very thing that we couldn't do. And that leads us to our third picture. Jesus paid for sin. See, each and every one of us, we owe a price for the sin in our lives. Sin has a nature, but it also has a destiny. And the destiny of sin is death. And that's a bleak picture, unless there's a beautiful end to that story. The Bible says that Jesus didn't just come and live a perfect life and walk on water and raise the dead to life. Jesus marched to a place called the cross. And at the cross, He stretched out His arms. And while He hung in agony, it wasn't just as a political prisoner or as a symbol of sacrifice. It was as an atoning Savior. You see, on the cross, Jesus made an exclamation. He said this, "It is finished." And here's what He meant. The claim of sin on your life, finished. The price that you deserve to pay for sin, finished and accomplished. The guilt you have to drag around with you through this world, finished. The fear that you have for death, finished. The Bible says that when Jesus died, every good reason for us to stay away from God died with Him. But that's not the end of the story. 3 days later, the Bible teaches that Jesus rose from the dead. And when Jesus rose, He opened a door forever for people like you and me to know God. And we know Him through belief. I wonder today if you've ever come to a personal place of knowing Jesus. The Bible says that there is no amount of good works that you can do to outweigh your past or outrun your mistakes. But today you're a person that God wants. He came for you. He lived for you. He died for you. He rose again for you. And in this moment, He wants to know you. The Bible says in Romans chapter 10 that anyone who wants this life with God simply has to believe in their heart that Jesus is who He says He is, and to confess and promise to give your life to God. And in that moment, if that's the choice that you're ready to make to follow Jesus, the picture comes true that Jesus spoke about in John 3, that you will be born again into a new spiritual life. Today, if you'd like to follow Jesus and take this step, I know how personal it can be. And so we want to provide some ways to walk with you. If you'd like to take this step, simply text Jesus to the number on your screen right now, and we'll reach back out to you. We would love to talk with you, to pray with you, to send you a Bible, and to join with you in this personal process. Hey, I want you to know that we exist to help people know God to the full. And I'm so grateful for you to take the time to watch this today, and I hope we can connect soon.